MEPs on Tuesday urged member states to step up the fight against tax havens and improve tax collection. The call for a pan-European blacklist of tax havens came ahead of the EU summit on Wednesday, when EU leaders are due to meet in Brussels to discuss ways to close the current 1 trillion euro tax gap in Europe.
The total loss of revenue due to illegal fraud and unacceptable evasion is estimated to be around 1 trillion euros a year. Let's put that into some perspective. 1 trillion euro is nearly double the 2012 combined annual budget deficit of all member states.
My proposal is maybe they can cancel the European Council of tomorrow and to hold a real ECOFIN meeting of the ministers of finance so that they can decide on concrete legislation. Concrete legislation on a blacklist of tax havens in Europe. Concrete legislation on a corporate common tax base, what we still not have in Europe, and concrete legislation on tax evasion. Because let's be honest, the conclusions of tomorrow, we have taken them already two times in the European Council.
The European Parliament also wants to make the exchange of banking information easier to improve transparency. Last week, EU finance ministers agreed to discuss the easing of bank secrecy with countries such as Switzerland, Monaco and Andorra.
Tomorrow, at the European Council, I will push for a political commitment on one very simple principle. That on the 1st January 2015, the European Union should have automatic exchange of information for all forms of income.
If we look at the officials that work for the European Commission and work for the European Parliament, the highest category are people that earn a net take-home pay of just over £100,000 a year. And yet, under EU rules, they pay tax of 12%. It's tax fraud on an absolutely massive scale. And Mr. Barroso, I would say to you, that how can that be deemed to be fair?
The debate in the European Parliament comes a day after UK Prime Minister David Cameron called on Britain's overseas territories to get their house in order over the sharing of tax information. He also told business leaders to stop avoiding paying taxes.